Hi, I'm Laura McIntosh, and I'm here to take you to school. Cooking school, right here at the Frito-Lay Flavor Kitchen. Now, I've got a crew of hungry football fans coming to my house to watch the big game, and I want to share with them and you winning recipe ideas. So, here's the game plan. Executive Chef Stephen Kalil has invited some of the best chefs in the country right here to the Flavor Kitchen to share with us busy moms how to make the most of fresh ingredients. Hey, Chef.
Hey, Laura. Welcome to the Flavor Kitchen.
Hey, well, you need to tell me. You've got a lot going on. What's happening in here?
Well, this is where we create flavors of all varieties, but most importantly, easy kitchen solutions for all you busy moms out there. But first, let's meet the taste of the NFL chefs, shall we?
Perfect.
Hi, I'm Jack McDavid. I represent the fanatical Philadelphia football fans. I cook at Jack's Firehouse and a down-home diner in Philadelphia. Jack's Firehouse and a down-home diner in Philadelphia both present American fare at its best. We go to the farms, we buy the food from the farms, we bring it in, we prepare everything fresh on the menu then. We have no freezers, we buy straight from the farms. The reason I use fresh ingredients is I think unless there's a purpose of drying or curing, the fresher the ingredients, the better there is. Now, a great piece of meat we need to age so it relaxes and tenderizes some natural process. But when you have fresh vegetables or fresh fish, you'll never get a better flavor than as soon as it's harvested.
Well, here we are, everyone, with Jack McDavid. Jack, thank you so much for being here and sharing with all of us busy moms out there how to put something delicious on our table for the big game.
Oh, thank you for having me, Laura. I'm from Philadelphia. It's a fanatical football city, okay?
All right. Well, I know they're patriotic, but they love their football.
They love football. They love full of flavors and easy to do. So we're doing a recipe today using red pepper, pesto, bruschetta.
I love that. Now, as long as it's quick and easy and I can do this ahead of time, I'm game.
It's actually a little bit better if you do it ahead of time.
Uh-huh.
What we're going to do is we're going to take some chopped tomatoes.
All right.
And we're going to put them in a bowl here.
All of them?
All of them,
all
man.
Right.
We like a lot of food.
I love tomatoes.
And then we're going to take our salt.
First?
Okay? We're going to put the salt in because that's going to help blend the flavors, melt the flavors, start almost melting the flavors together.
So it's the tomatoes?
It's the tomatoes.
Okay.
It makes it a little wet.
All right.
And now we're going to start putting in a little bit of garlic.
All right. How much of this garlic
do you
want?
Oh, put the garlic. We want flavors.
Are you going to make me do it with my hands?
Oh, no. I gave you some spoons, ma'am.
How much? Just
all of the garlic.
All of it?
Yes. Okay. Full of flavor.
Full of flavor. Wow.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
And then we're going to add the onions.
All right.
I'm going to stir it up a little bit.
Okay.
Now, this is going to be a lot of flavor. We're going to go with the basil.
And all of it.
All of it,
ma'am.
We measured it out earlier. We got it just perfect.
Okay.
Now, we're going to go to the red peppers.
Now, what did you do? Did we roast these?
We roasted these, blackened them, okay?
Ooh.
And then put them in a paper bag. About 5 minutes later, we'll come back and the peels will come right off for you.
How easy.
As easy as can be. And now the salt is starting to work. So now we're going to add our cheese.
And all of it, right?
All of
it. Okay.
This is going to be a great flavor.
A little parmesan.
Yes, ma'am. We've got this, and now it's all working together. Now we're going to add some pecans.
Or pecans.
Pecans, either one, whichever makes you happy, ma'am.
All of it again.
Okay.
A nice little crunch in there.
Yes, ma'am. And now we're going to do our black pepper.
Okay. All of it?
All of it.
All of it.
Okay. And now we're going to go to the oil.
All right.
And we're not going to pour it all at once, but we're going to pour it a little bit so I can work it in as we go, okay?
So why are we pouring it slow?
We're pouring it so we can work it in and call it emulsion almost.
All right.
Okay?
This is very fresh.
We have this done, okay?
Yes.
And now we can start putting the magic together. Now, we're going to take these beautiful scoops.
Tostitos scoops. I love them. The corn chips, they're fabulous.
We have a scoop for the weekend, yes?
We do have the scoop for the weekend. Are you going to tell us who's going to win the big game?
Of course. Whoever scores the most points.
I love it. It's true.
All right.
It's true.
And now we can go back to our spoon.
Okay.
Now we're going to fill the scoop. You going to help me?
Okay.
Okay.
Easy to do. Look at that. It's a perfect scoop. It fits in there perfectly. Now, you created this recipe, right?
Yes, I created it. It goes real well with this time of year. It's simple. You can do it a little bit ahead.
Jack, I'm filling it full as well.
Yes.
I like it like that.
You know, they look so good, we want to try them. Maybe
okay, why did you use basil? Talk to me about the basil.
All the way through my food, I use farm fresh ingredients.
Yes.
I want full of flavor. I want it fresh and quick and simple.
And I love the fresh flavors. How are we doing?
We're doing well.
All right, well, we're going to fill up this plate, get it nice and pretty. And you guys need to check out this recipe. Jack, thanks so much for helping us and creating this wonderful recipe. What are you calling it?
We'll call this the Big Scoop.
I love it. The Big Scoop for the big game. Thanks, Jack.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.